الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. One of the scholars of the past, he said, كنت أن أظن أن الله سبحانه وتعالى هو الذي يحب أولا حتى قرأت قوله تعالى فسوف يأتي الله بقوم يحبهم ويحبونهم فعلمت عند ذلك أن الله سبحانه وتعالى هو الذي يحب أولا ثم كنت أظن أن الله سبحانه وتعالى هو الذي يتوب على العبد أولا حتى قرأت قول الله تعالى ثم تاب عليهم ليتوبوا فعلمت عند ذلك أن الله سبحانه وتعالى هو الذي يتوب على العبد أولا ثم كنت أظن أن الله سبحانه وتعالى هو الذي يرضى عن العبد أولا حتى قرأت قوله تعالى رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه فعلمت عند ذلك أن الله سبحانه وتعالى هو الذي يرضى عن عبده أولا. One of the scholars of the past, he said that I used to think that the servant was the one who had to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and love him first. Until I read the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala where he said that soon will Allah bring a new people who he will love them and they will love him. And he said, and I learned after reading that ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that loves you first and not you love him first. Because if you notice in the ayat, Allah says, فَسَوْفَ يَأْتِ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَهُمْ That Allah will love them and they will love him. He says, so I learned after reading that ayat that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that loves first. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that loves first. And there's actually a hadith al-Qudsi where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَبْنَ آدَمْ أَنَا لَكَ مُحِبْ فَبِحَقِّي عَلَيْكَ كُنْ لِي مُحِبًّا O son of Adam, I love you. So based upon my right over you, love me. O son of Adam, I love you. So based upon my right over you, love me. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that loves first. Even as we read in the ayah, as we're going to talk about in the next line, that in the ayah and the imam recited after Fajr, he mentioned the story of the creation of Adam. And as I go into the next line, he said, I used to think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the servant was the one who had to turn to Allah in repentance first, before Allah turned to the servant. He said, but then I read the verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ثُمَّ تَابَ عَلَيْهِمْ لِيَتُوبُ Then Allah turned to them and repented to accept their repentance, and then they turned and repented. He said, and I learned after reading that ayah that Allah is the one that turns to the servant first, and then the servant turns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in forgiveness. Meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He accepts our repentance, He already knew that we were going to sin and repent, and He knew that He was going to forgive us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's knowledge is not restricted to time. Allah told the angels, إِنِّي جَائِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَ That I'm going to place on the earth a khalifa, meaning Adam and his progeny. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not create Adam on the earth. He created Adam in paradise, in Jannah. So when he told the angels, I was going to place on the earth a khalifa, he was informing the angels about an incident that had already taken place. Meaning, Adam was going to eat from the tree. Allah was going to turn to Adam and teach Adam how to repent and then accept his repentance. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Ibn Qayyim mentions in a very beautiful passage, he said, this shows you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave Adam even before he committed the sin. Allah forgave Adam even before he committed the sin because he told the angels, I'm going to place on the earth a khalifa. But he placed on the earth a khalifa after Adam sinned and repented and accepted his repentance and removed him from paradise and then placed him on the earth. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of his mercy, he said that, فَعَلِمْتُ عِنْدَ ذَٰلِكَ فَعَنُّوا After reading that ayah,
that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who directs the servant to repent and then turns and accepts his repentance. Subhanallah. When Allah tells us in the Quran, لَا تَيْأَسُ مِنْ رَوْحِ اللَّهِ, do not despair over the mercy of Allah. Allah tells us that after knowing that we were going to sin, knowing the sins that we were going to commit, and then He tells us, don't despair over my mercy. Subhanallah. Look at the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That He already knows that we're going to sin, and yet He still tells us, don't despair over His mercy. Allah knows that we are going to sin, and He directs us to repent, and then He accepts our repentance. How much more mercy can you expect from your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala? He said, I used to think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was the one, that the servant was the one who had to be pleased with Allah first. He said, until I read the ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, radiyallahu anhum wa radu an, that Allah is pleased with them and they are pleased with Allah. Notice Allah is pleased with the servant first, and then the servant is pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, so I learned after reading that ayah that Allah is the one that is pleased with His servants first, and then the servants turn into Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being pleased with Him. And so why I'm saying this is that if you notice in each of the sentences, he said, I used to think this. And the clarification only came to him after he read the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not just read the book of Allah, but pondered and reflected over these ayats. He said, I used to think that the servant was the one that had to love Allah first. And then I read the verse where Allah says that Allah will bring a people who He will love them and they will love Him. He said, and look at the sequence. That's not haphazardly. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that sequence to show us His hikmah, that Allah loves first and then the servants love Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turns to us to accept our repentance first, and then He directs us to repent and then accepts our repentance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with His creation first, and then the servants have to, at somewhere along the line in their journey, they have to learn how to be pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have to learn how to be pleased to Allah, pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are just some words of wisdom that we can gather from some of the scholars of the past, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He assists us, He aids us in remembering Him and turning to Him in forgiveness, and aids us in loving Him. Because it becomes very difficult for the servant when he doesn't understand Allah's loves. You know, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you, He tests you. And sometimes we look at the tests that come to us in our lives and we think that it is an indication that Allah doesn't love us. We think we determine that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't love us because of this, or because of this trial and this test. But that may be an indication that Allah does love you. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِذَا أَحَبُّ اللَّهُ قَوْمٍ ابْتَلَاهُمْ, that when Allah loves a people, He tests them. So your test may be, in fact, an indication that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you. You are the one that has the problem with the love, because you have to navigate through the trials and the tribulations that Allah gives you to find out whether or not you truly love Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you, and an indication of His love is that He tests you. But we have to search within ourselves and navigate through our journey to find out whether or not we truly love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's not Allah that has the love problem, it is the human being that has the love problem. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turns to us to accept our repentance, but sometimes it can take us a lifetime to truly repent. It can take us a lifetime before we finally come to the realization that we need to repent sincerely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in the Quran, وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, and turn all of you to Allah in repentance, O you who believe, so that perhaps you may attain success. Perhaps you may attain success. So Allah is commanding us to turn to Him, but He has already turned to us. So it is not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that has the problem with turning towards us. It is us that have a problem turning towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the same thing with being pleased. Being pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes it can take us a lifetime before we come to the realization, رَضِيتُ بِاللَّهِ رَبًّا وَإِسْلَامِ دِينًا وَمُحَمَّدٍ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ رَسُولًا. It can take us a lifetime to come to the realization that I am pleased with Allah as my Lord, and Islam is my deen, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is my messenger. So we straddle the fence with that. Because with us, being pleased with Allah is conditional. That is, as long as Allah is feeding us and blessing us and giving us this, we're pleased with Him. But the moment that comes to a halt, then our pleasure is now become compromised. So it is not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has the problem being pleased with His servants. It is the servants that have a problem being pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Being pleased with His qadr. Being pleased with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed for us. Being pleased with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen for us. Being pleased with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with. And this is what I wanted to present, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallama tasliman kathira wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.